Okay, welcome back to round one of a Kaladesh draft. We're on the draw. This hand is pretty good. Can curve out pretty well, so we'll keep. Probably just go ahead and play mechanic on two. Guess we'll see what they do, if that makes sense or not. I guess if they're going to play a 2-3 that blanks my mechanic, that doesn't really make any sense. I mean, I can attack back, which is the only real reason to do that, but could just get value from it later with my pioneer. So I guess we'll just pass the turn. Might regret that if they go very aggressive or immediately kill my rhino or something, but yeah, it's kind of the plus side of cards like this. You know, it can do something turn two, or it can do something, you know, turn five or whatever. Like, so I get a trumpeter, which could get scary pretty fast. Green certainly, at least red doesn't, but green has plenty of ways to get plus one counters on creatures, so. That they're attacking with this and not the trumpeter indicates either that they have the Chandra's Power Helix, I guess, to deal two damage divided, or they don't have a trick and it's just a free attack, because there's not really a lot of reason to not attack with the Trumpeter if they have a trick. So I think it's just a free attack is my guess, if they want to spend their turn casting a red damage spell in addition, whatever. Okay, so it is what we thought. They don't get to add to the board this turn, so it's not that. Really, do get to add to the board this turn. I regret everything. Now, granted, I couldn't really play my fight card into that anyway, so not actually a huge loss, but. I would like to use the ability. Do I want a Glint Sleeve Artisan? Probably. There's some argument for I want a land so I can cast Edgecrafters in a couple turns. Like, next turn I can cast Wild Wanderer, and the next turn if I draw a land I can Edgecrafter. If I don't draw a land, I can always, like, Artisan Mechanic, which is okay. I guess this is probably good. Probably good enough, anyway. Presumably just end up trading this off. I guess given that we have Inspire Charge and no double green cards, I probably want a Plains. Well, we'll see. If they have something, they have something. I guess, again, unlikely they had a pump spell, or they would have attacked with the Warden also. Well, unfortunately, we did not draw the land for our Edgecrafter, so I guess we have to think a little bit now. Can cast Artisan and Mechanic. I mean, we can also cast Mechanic and return a land, and that means we can cast Pioneer 2. Is that better than, like, basically, do we care about getting value with this card compared to stabilizing the board? Because we could just Artisan and just make a 3-3, and that kind of stonewalls them a little bit. Not good with our future Inspired Charges, but with Edgecrafters, that's probably not going to be that big of a deal. Yeah, 1-1's not doing a lot in this board, and we are on our back foot a little bit, so I suppose we'll just make a 3-3. Alright, then we will Avery Mechanic. I guess we'll pick up a Plains and replay it. Can't hurt to make them think about a pump spell that we don't actually have in our deck, which is Built to Last, +2/+2. If it's an artifact, else it's indestructible. So we can see on this board, Edgecrafters could not be traded with, basically, because they only have one creature that can even block it. Brawler is good. All right, so now what we got to figure out is, do we want to fabricate, making more servos, or do we want to have a giant creature? Now, 3-4 is already bigger than most of their stuff. So I guess, given that we do play two Inspired Charges in our deck, 3-4 is probably a little better than 5-6. I guess we also have Master Trinketer, I think it's called. We have the creature that pumps all our servos, whatever the name may be. We possibly could have attacked the Aviary Mechanic. No, that probably doesn't make sense, but something to at least consider. So this is basically more elegant. It turns all my guys into elegant Edgecrafters, I guess. We'll, I think, attempt to trade our Glintsleeve Artisan for this creature. If they play something, oh well. Foiled. Didn't count on them having their own Edgecrafter. That does complicate my life. So I cannot hunt the weak that. I can multiple block it, and they probably don't really have anything else. So, I guess if we're gonna do that, then I'd rather trade my guide than my pioneer. Could also, like, attack into it with my current Edgecrafters and, like, 3-for-1 myself, but that does not sound like something I want to do. Now, is that just random chance, or just do different cards create different servo art? Like, these are both the same, and then this coming from this card is different? A little weird. Alright, well, they're attacking with their Edgecrafters. Now, I can take 5 and go to 9. Like, if they have any trick, I do get blown out by it. But, can't really, like, chump this creature or anything, so if I'm gonna have to eventually block it anyway, I might as well just double block it now. Like, there's really been no indication they have a trick. If they have drawn one, okay. Ordering that way somewhat... Well, that probably just suggests they think I have built to last. Then I can make my guy a 5-6. Alright, maybe they're not thinking about built to last. If they have no trick, it would kind of make sense to put edge crafters first, unless they think I have built to last. Because then I could save my creature and theirs dies. So they would want to put this first to guarantee they kill something. Alright, well, that worked out fine for me. We'll see what giant thing they're about to play, but... Alright. Well, that can be jump blocked anyway. Okay. So... I count the weak something, but really it's just Eager Construct, which is not that great. So I guess I Pioneer. Question being, do I make a 3-2 or do I make another 1-1 for if and when I draw my Inspired Charge? I mean, I think I'm probably going to try and win in the air with this eventually, so I guess I just put the counter on. I'm not really short on creatures. I also left the wrong land up. Like, I've been leaving white land up this whole time, but, like, my puzzle knot now, I now can't crack my puzzle knot and use my quote-unquote build to last that I would have used last turn anyway, I suppose, so. Alright. Do I need this right now? I don't think so. Yeah, I think I can just trade off with these things. So I block this and a 1-1 here. I block this here. I could just take 9. Do I want to take 9? I guess I can double block the Wild Wanderer. Could also just take 8. Block like here instead. It's probably better. Alright. Still hunt the weak this next turn, I guess. Yeah, this is sort of a downside of hunt the weak in this sort of deck, where, you know, there's definitely, like, could have potentially used it with my Glintsleeve Artisan when it was a 3-3 to kill something, but sometimes you just have a bunch of small guys. Alright. Hunt the weak here. And I think I'm gonna attack with everything but one chump blocker, which leaves me dead if they have anything, but it seems like the best way to possibly win is to just chump this for a few turns and hope we draw a way to kill it, or, you know, draw Inspired Charge or whatever. Well, that is going to get 3 damage, but that's not... doesn't kill me, so I don't care that much. So I guess Master Trinketeer would probably be the best draw right now. I would say... Plains would be the worst draw if I had to rate my draws. Now I guess I can just trade with their artist. I am then relying on the top of my deck, like, to find my revoke privileges or whatever it's called, the fast pacifism, but I don't think double chumping is a good way to try and win this game, so. Said blossoming defense there, which I guess is a good thing to know they have. You know, they had plenty of times cast combat tricks before, so I think they just happened to draw it. Yeah, I guess no reason to show them more cards in our deck. Alright. We don't really have anything that's particularly good against them. Stomper might be okay. Crew 5 is like a ton, so I don't know if that's really reasonable to expect to be able to do in our deck. Takedown wouldn't do anything. Yeah, this card certainly could be good against them, but I'm not sure that it's realistic to expect to crew very often. Probably a good strategy would just be to draw a little bit better. Maybe I should have played the mechanic turn two, or waited to get actual value out of it. I don't know. I would like to play first. Yeah, I mean, I'll keep. It's I don't really want both of those in my opening hand. Like, one of them's good enough, but whatever. Turn 3 Rhino is pretty nice, or Artisan, so. I guess Artisan's slightly better. Huh. Now this is a little bit interesting. Probably better to get things in play when I already have the Inspired Charge, but it's like I could just get a little bit of value off my Glint Sleeve, but. Nah, I'm okay. Alright, well, they don't have the 2-3. I like that. Or the guy that puts a counter but can be a 2-3. So at least I can attack with my guy. I guess given that we don't have another land anyway, might as well just Rhino. Assuming we get to draw planes, like, just at some point in the game, it seems like we're probably pretty favored to win this game on the play when we're gonna just get to keep adding to the board, and, you know, our two guys we can already cast right now both make two creatures. But, I guess we'll see. I'll not block your 4-3. What do you got? My hope would be nothing, but I'm going to assume that's not the case. Alright, so they had Chandra's Pyrohelix, which, whatever. They could have the untap spell, which is annoying. Does Inspired Charge beat that card? So it's a 4-5. It does if I want to do it, I think, right? Because my guy's going to be 5, his guy's going to be 5. So I guess I cannot get totally blown out here, and if they don't have it, yeah, then I just get nice attack in, so. Alright. So we'll glint sleeve. Just make a 1/1. And given that we have a bunch of 1/1s coming in the next couple turns, it is nice that they already spent their Pyro Helix, which they could have more than one of, but the one we know about. I would say we took one from them, but that's not how leagues work. They just drafted with totally different people, so. Alright, so they have their Seed Sculptor, luckily on turn 4 instead of turn 2. So they can make the guy 5/3. Whatever, it's fine. Sorry, 5/4. Can revoke privileges this guy. It's not like a huge need to. Could attack with everything, and if they block Inspired Charge and they take quite a bit and lose their only guy, and then I can just Inspired Charge against next turn, that's probably the best play. They're not exactly going to be cracking back for the win here. And if they don't block, we'll just High Spire Artisan. So, let's see what they play, but presumably it's going to be like one creature, and my next Inspired Charge probably does a similar thing. The Brawler can probably just trade with whatever it blocks, assuming they don't block the Rhino, but... Alright, 4/5 is in my way. Attacking with that's real ambitious. Like, very likely to just die. Could revoke privileges and attack with my 3/4. I could cast High Spire Artisan and attack with a bunch of things next turn. Yeah, I can't really imagine they attack next turn, so I'll just add it to my board. It's fine. This probably is somewhat revealing that I have another Inspired Charge, but what are you going to do? So, if they just, like, tap out for another big guy, I guess they're not literally dead, because they could just go to one if they don't block Artisan and Servo, but they're certainly not in good shape. Though it is bad if they get to Edgecrafters next turn. Yeah, I don't think... Like, maybe a couple turns ago I was just supposed to play the Artisan and not attack with my Servo. Alright, well, Ornamental Courage I think just kills them. Because I can Inspired Charge and that. So, like, if these two things are unblocked, then... That's 3, 4, 5, and then a 6 with courage. So they don't think they can have anything. Because I guess I think the only like single red spell is built to smash, which they cast on my creature right now, that's about it. And even if they could, even if it just was giant growth, that doesn't do anything here, so hopefully I'm not missing some rare shock or something, but I don't think I am. Yeah, I think their deck is probably kind of good against mine, like the Outrider and the Wayward Giant, and they just have guys that are slightly bigger than mine. You know, could still beat them by going wide like this, but a little harder than if the guys matched up a little more closely. Think they could make better blocks than that. Maybe this should have blocked here. Probably, yeah, but whatever. Now they're just making me wonder if I'm missing some card. Well, that was very pleasant for Magic Online interactions, so kudos to... Alright, yeah, I mean, we saw more of the deck, but I still don't really know what we're supposed to do. I mean, Stomper, like, could be okay. It still just feels more like a card that would be good in their sideboard against a deck similar to theirs compared to my deck, which... Probably might have to tap four creatures to crew five. So, alright. I don't think we want Automaton, so. I think we'll just hope that we either get a similar curve or draw one of our grindier cards, our Ovaya or Trinketeer. Alright, I think this hand is too bad. I mean, this is not a turn four play. And so we're not doing anything till turn 5 or 6. I mean, their deck seems pretty aggressive. Seems like a pretty good deck. So I don't think that's really reasonable. So we're going to mulligan. Man, this is just taunting me. Just no green for the Ovaya. I don't know that it would really even be a keep if I did have the forest. But I don't think I can keep this. Oh. I guess we just hope we draw some lands. I don't think we want to go any further down, so. Forgot this card was in our deck. I haven't seen it yet. Could say that about the Trinketeer also, but I was talking about that Etrilhawk. Alright, so we gotta draw runner, lands. No big deal. I guess we get to 4, it's not that bad. Alright, come on, Plains. Ooh, alright. This is going to unfortunately be not a very interesting game to watch. I mean, our first hand looks great at this point, but I think it was a mulligan, so oh well. If we do hit, like, next turn and hit the following turn, then we're not totally screwed, but I think much more than that, we're in really bad shape. Even as it is that our 2-drop is a creature that doesn't actually trade with their creatures, is not great. Alright, so start. Can just... Assuming we draw a land, we'll play Guide next turn, because we want to trade that off a lot more than we want to trade off Trinketeer. Yep, take it. All Trinketeer does give us something to do with our four mana or whatever, but even if we drew a fourth mana, we would still cast the creature, so. Not that there's a lot of things that Aatrolhawk trades with, but I do not like that they keep playing creatures that do not trade with it. Alright, I don't think we can win this game. Alright, well, I'm going to concede. I will see you guys next round.